I'm that pissed off. I'm that pissed off.
The footy's starting tomorrow. Why would you be pissed off?
Well, I was driving around a couple of weeks ago and I heard the cricket on the radio.
Mm.
I didn't even know the cricket was on. What? Australia is playing Test cricket and I had no idea that we were playing Test cricket.
Who were we playing against?
We were playing against New Zealand. I thought about the entire summer of cricket that I didn't watch. Hardly watched a thing. And I was told yesterday, all right, no need for the cone of silence. I'm happy for this just to exist.
Yep.
One of the reasons that you don't hear about where cricket is played these days is because of all the cricket and the expense of all the cricket that is played at the moment. And I'll let you just be the judge what that means. Every lick of cricket that is played under the Australian banner is the reason that they have no money to let us know where Australia is playing.
Is that because the players are getting too much?
I don't think so. I think it is just because...
Or is it the broadcasters not letting us know?
Because there are so many teams, men's, women's, 50-50, 50 cricket, 20-20 cricket.
Test cricket.
Test cricket, state cricket. There is so much cricket and so much expense, they don't have a budget to let us know when they actually... They are playing cricket.
I got a theory on this. See, here's my theory. I reckon cricket, you check out of it when the Australian Open tennis starts.
Correct.
You check out and it's done.
It's done.
I don't care. I don't care. After the Sydney test, I don't care.
But in the old days, I used to love playing against the West Indies and New Zealand.
Yeah.
And the Bunnies were the Indians, the Pakistanis. But now...
The Windies were incredible.
Yeah, the Windies were incredible. Yeah. Now, it's... I only want to watch us versus England or us versus India. They're the only two countries I want to play against.
What about South Africa?
No, because I wouldn't know, other than de Kock, I would not know any other cricketers.
Excuse you.
Have to say it like that.
Other than de Kock, I wouldn't know any other. I wouldn't know. You wouldn't know. And your point you make is good. I think the broadcasters have a lot to do because a lot of it's now on pay TV. And a lot of people consume television on free-to-air, you just don't see it.
That's right. I was just driving, it was a few weeks ago, I was just driving in, so flick it over to SEN. It's not Jared Waitley, it's Australia playing New Zealand.
Yeah.
And I didn't even know we were playing New Zealand.
I didn't know that either.
There's something wrong with that. Isn't there something wrong with that?
Well, I think too much is, you know, if you're eating chicken pasta every day, you're not going to like chicken pasta after a week. But if you're having chicken pasta once every 6 weeks, it's actually quite good.
So the NRL season started last weekend in Vegas.
Yeah.
The AFL season starts tomorrow night.
Yeah.
Do you, and it's probably more a you question here, Ox, do you give two hoots about preseason trial matches or not?
Nope. Not a zack about it, other than injuries.
Yeah,
that's it.
Other than injuries, that's all I care about is injuries. I know. Yeah, Melbourne had a good win over Carlton a couple of weeks ago, and do we get confident about it? No, not at all, because we also had a bad loss the week before.
Any injuries? I can't remember.
Melbourne.
Yeah. None.
No, only half the teams in rehab. Other than that, we're going along beautifully.
On that, Ox, the Dees have been going through a tough time. There's been a lot of stuff going on, and we're all aware of what's being talked about. As a former Dee, when you read that and hear that, and you would hear things, I presume, that none of us do because you're kind of in a sanctum guy, how do you feel about that? How does it make you feel about your old club?
I think a lot of it's got to do with the board problems that they had a while ago with Glenn Bartlett, and I think there's stuff being rehashed. I think Melbourne's biggest problem is they didn't get a deal done with Glenn Bartlett just to sever ties, because now it's going to go to court. And what happens when it goes to court, it becomes public. And there is some stuff that Glenn Bartlett, being a very qualified high lawyer, will have up his sleeve that'll blow some things open. And I just think there's a storm brewing.
Really?
And it's going to get a lot worse before it gets a lot better.
So now, Bartlett knows where all the bodies are buried?
I'd say yes. And he might have buried a few of them. I don't know. I don't know the whole situation, but court will unravel a lot of stuff. So I think there's people agitating behind the scenes. But that happens. It's cyclical, isn't it? You know, it happened to Richmond many years ago, and then it happened to Carlton, and Collingwood have had their trials and tribulations, and the West Coast Eagles and the Adelaide Crows. So Melbourne are the vogue side at the moment.
Just on that, when he was talking about this on 3AW, it went on all their social media. There was a picture of you. And you know what the feedback was to me? That you were wearing a Titleist hat.
Oh, really?
Everyone loved your Titleist hat.
Oh, good.
One, not many people. I mean, when there's something in the news about the Dees, I mean, you're very good at it. You always make good points. But, geez, I had a little smile when people were texting me going, how good's Ox with the Titleist hat on the social
media? Nick Arnold likes it. I hope he's into it.
Kim, I know you've got a business idea. Can I just get one more civil selfishness out of the way?
Yeah, absolutely. So was that last one a civil selfishness about cricket?
Cricket Australia, very selfish. Yeah. Please let us know next summer, in fact, right throughout the year, when we're playing cricket. I'd like to know.
I'll give him a business idea. Come up with a new jingle.
There you go. Okay.
Come up with a new jingle. You know, come on, Aussie, come on. It was a long time ago. Come up with a new jingle and revitalise our love and want to watch cricket.
Well, I'll tell you what I will do. If you can come up with a new jingle, get in contact with us. We will put it on our socials. And if it's any good, I'll give you a box of Titleist golf balls. Very, very simple.
And a hat.
And Ox will give you a hat.
And I'll give you a hat.
So hang on. So you're asking someone from the family to write a jingle that would normally cost a huge amount of money for Cricket Australia.
That's right.
And as a thank you, they get a box of golf balls.
That's right.
And a hat.
And a hat.
It's 100 bucks worth.
And we will send the episode to Cricket Australia. Yep. We'll send it to Steve Smith and Ricky Ponting, who refuses to come on this podcast.
Oh, yes. Who's our mate that used to work at Cricket Australia?
James Sutherland. No,
the other one.
Oh, I know who you're talking about.
He went to Metcash.
He's a great bloke.
Scotty.
Scotty. We'll think of it later. Yep. He ended up with going to Tennis Australia.
Yeah, he did.
He went everywhere, that bloke.
What's your other civil selfishness?
You know where I live, it's a very leafy street. It's a beautiful, what do you call that? When the
canopy.
A beautiful canopy in my street in Hampton. It's gorgeous.
The canopy actually hangs right over the social housing. It's just gorgeous in Hampton.
I can see why the social housing people live on the street. It's a beautiful street.
When you're sitting outside on your chair,
fantastic,
smoking or doing a hit, there's nothing better than having good shade.
Just tune in next week, folks. I've got a ripper on the social housing in my bloody house. Anyway, because of that canopy, there's an awful lot of leaves fall.
Oh, yeah.
During summer, an awful lot. Oh. And I like my house to be nice and neat.
Your leaves different. Mine normally drop in autumn.
Do they? Anyway. Anyway, I was raking them up the other day and I got my gloves on and I've got the biggest pile of
leaves. You
don't
rake them up, do you? You blow them up. You blow them into the pile.
It gets stuck on the kikuyu on the front lawn. My kikuyu is so thick and lush.
And all the leaves also go under the dog poo because you've got landmines everywhere.
They nestle in.
Yep.
So anyway, after a half an hour's hard labour out the front.
Please.
Getting all these leaves into a huge pile. I'm just about to put them into the green bin when I see a flashing light at the end of the street. It's the street sweeper.
He's lost.
He's lost. So I put to you, these rotten councils, they are completely hopeless. That was a fluke. I fluked it that he came down the street at the right time.
Did you put them into the...
I sat there, they were all into the gutter and I was about to put them in my green bin. And then the guy came down and he just went whoosh. And every leaf went up beautifully. My front lawn had never been cleaner. It looked magnificent. It's pretty bloody selfish that the councils couldn't send you a text message telling you that the street sweeper's coming down. Wouldn't that be simple?
If I'm a street sweeper though, I'm just going down the street that I know there's no cars. Yes. So I can actually get close to the gutter.
That's right. So there's two reasons. One, you get all the leaves into the gutter, all set for the street sweeper to come. Two, you can get your car parked off the street.
That's a good idea.
So why can't they send you a text message?
Well, talking about bins, because I've got a first world problem. Yeah. I've been doing it.
Which was Marco's was as well, I reckon.
Yeah, well, that is a first world.
But no, that was civil selfishness.
But I'm fixing up a house up in rural Victoria and we got a big skip. Like a big one. It'd be probably 6 metres by 4 metres. Like it's a really big bin that goes in the back of a truck. So almost full. Anyway, we put a ring on our door. You know, one of those ring doorbells which has a camera?
Yeah.
So if anyone goes past, you get notifications. Well, the amount of people that are going through our bin trying to pick up a, I don't know what they're looking for, but it might be a bit of timber or thing, but also people who have no affiliation with us at all are putting shit into our bin.
That's disgusting.
Without even asking.
Right.
That's not very nice.
That's not very friendly. Well, if he knocked on our door and said, or they, knocked on our door, it's a he, and he's done it multiple times, because we've got it on the ring. He's been caught. He hasn't got a mask on. I know who he is. I'm going to let his ties down. Anyway, he keeps putting stuff in our bin. Now, is that kosher?
He's a repeat offender.
Yeah, three times.
That's average.
Oh, that's...
And he's on an electric bike.
Are you kidding me?
Nah.
He turns up in an electric bike.
Yeah, electric bike.
How old is this bloke?
Is it a hilly street?
Maybe 40 or 50.
Oh. Is it a hilly street?
No.
Is it a hilly area?
No, it's as flat as a pancake.
Why is he got an electric bike for?
Because he's a lazy, dirty dog.
So you haven't got an issue with people taking stuff out there?
No, take whatever you want.
Yeah.
Take whatever you want out of the bin. But if you want to put something in the bin because you can't, you know, whatever, let us know and we're happy to accommodate.
I hazard a guess. If he knocked on your door and said, hey, Ox, would you mind if I just dumped this thing in that skip?
No problem.
You'd go,
knock yourself out, buddy. No problem, champ. But he does it under the stealth of darkness. But our little – can I just say this?
Yeah.
That guy who came up with the ring doorbell?
Yeah.
Credit to you, sir.
Genius.
He's a multi-billionaire.
Genius.
He's a multi-multi
– So do you see that footage on your iPhone? Does it get sent to your iPhone?
Yeah, so it comes up straight away, goes – ring.
So would you consider wandering down to the electric bike man and knocking on the door and just showing him the repeated offence?
So the neighbour across the road, right, so Mark.
Yes.
Now,
sounds like a good bloke
so
already.
So Mark and Meredith, right, they live together. They've got chooks in their front yard.
They do.
No, they do. They've got six or seven chooks. And where is it?
Where are we
at? We're up on the river, on the Murray River. Let's just say Orby Wodonga area. So and Mark and Meredith are rippers. Yes. Mark's a little bit out there. Yeah. Doesn't like to talk around satellites. Dishes on the roof.
Really?
Yeah, because people are listening.
Oh,
But he's a ripper. I said to him the other day, because I was leaving, I said, we're going away for 3 days. Can you keep an eye on the place? He goes, mate, I'm all over it. There is no one's going to get into this house without me knowing.
What a start.
I said, no problem. He said, there is one guy that comes around and occasionally turns taps on and does some naughty stuff.
What?
He used to live in the house next door and he got evicted. And anyway, like all that sort of stuff. So he's a little bit jaded. So I said to him, I don't like telling lies, but I told Mark a lie. I said, Mark, I know you know this guy. Yeah. Just let him know we're connected to the bikies. All right? So I had Big Sigo there, and Sigo looks like a bikie. And Mark goes, all done. And he goes, I know where he lives. I said, if any trouble happens, I'll point out his house, and you and your bikie mates can go down there and see him. So now the word's out. We've got bikies living in the street.
That is so good.
So that's my first world problem. People putting stuff into my skip bin rather than actually asking for it.
Can I go one step further than the skip bin? Normal bins. Is it okay to use your neighbour's bin if yours is full and B, theirs is like half full, and C, it's really close to when the garbo's coming, so all this stuff's
no here. Problem.
Excellent question.
No problem at all.
Only on bin day.
Only on bin day, exactly right.
Only on bin day.
Because at the moment my bin in where I live, just before drop-off or just before pick-up, a lot of babies' nappy bags have been put in there. So someone in our street's got some babies.
That's right.
So, which I don't mind.
Yeah.
Which I don't mind. But don't put it in – I don't put my bin out until the early morning of or the night before.
Yeah.
Don't put it out too early. If you put it out too early, you're asking for trouble.
Mm.
Asking for trouble. Now, I've got a business idea.
Have you?
I've got a business idea.
You look excited.
Now, this one could make us millionaires.
Trademarked or not yet?
Not yet, but okay. I'm just about to do it.
All right.
We need to employ our own trademark person.
Yeah, just,
we need
a lawyer.
We need fast
Brian
action.
Brian Goldberg.
Well, Dennis DeLudo will know someone.
Brian Goldberg is a patent officer, patent lawyer,
right,
and a good mate of mine, and he will look after us.
Dennis is good with patents, though.
Yeah, he is. He's good at copying patents.
Yeah. I like the sound of Brian, though.
All right. Now, this is for every lonely person out there.
Okay.
All right.
I know a few lonely types.
Okay. Lonely people drive their cars all the time because they're lonely, all right?
So, well, they just drive around aimlessly.
Well, Yeah, but they're driving by themselves. They're not talking to anyone. They pull up. I've got an idea.
Go on.
All right. Coffee cup.
Yeah.
Or handbag glued to your roof of your car. Now, think about it. You're driving down the freeway and there's a coffee cup on the roof of your car. Do you know how many people are going to make contact with you to let you know that you've got a coffee cup on the roof of your car? You will pull up and there'll be a coffee cup there and the guy, a beautiful looking lady will come across the road. Excuse me, sir, you've got a coffee cup. Oh, well, thank you for that. It's just a clip-on. You take it off. You've met somebody. You do a handbag. Imagine doing a handbag on top, say a Louis Vuitton handbag. You put that on the roof.
Yeah.
You're driving off. If you saw someone with a Louis Vuitton handbag, you'd be following them. Imagine how many conversations you would have in 1 week if you had a fake coffee cup or a fake Louis Vuitton handbag on the roof of your car.
You know what this is? This is the lonely person's doggy.
Yep.
Little puppy.
Yep.
It's a lonely person's
on the
puppy.
Roads. Yep. It is a great way to meet people.
Yeah.
And you pull up and you got a Louis Vuitton handbag on the top of your car.
Yep.
Imagine the conversations you would have.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you. You know, you've just saved me, you know. Oh, by the way, you doing anything tonight?
There you go.
It is a conversation starter.
Do you think people would be a little annoyed when they realise it's a fake handbag
they wouldn't
that
know.
Clips onto your car?
They wouldn't know.
Oh, they wouldn't know.
Okay. No, thank you so much. Now, you wouldn't take it once. You wouldn't put a bassinet on there or you wouldn't do anything silly.
No.
You wouldn't go for the sympathy vote or you wouldn't put a fake dog on there. But a wallet, a coffee cup or a handbag.
Sunnies,
mobile phone. There's about seven or eight things. You'd mix it up.
Yeah.
You'd mix it up depending upon where you were.
What about if you forgot it was up there and you found yourself driving through, let's say, Frankston?
Well, that's when you have your gun up there. That's when you have a fake gun up there. Yeah. But I think it could work.
Have you progressed to the stage of a name for the coffee cup or the fake Louis Vuitton?
No. It might be
The listener out there will know. They'll be thinking, they'll be working for us.
Yeah.
And they can become business partners with a couple of blokes.
I'm thinking about taking this one to the den.
It's a great idea. I like it. Do you know the funny thing? It's funny you raise business ideas. We had a message from one of the family members this week who's got a business idea, but he needs your help with it, Ox.
Oh, really?
Let's go.
He wants a slogan.
Okay.
So now we've spoken to.
What's his name? Do we know?
Yeah, Darren the Banker.
He's back.
He's back.
He's been on a couple of times.
Yes.
Is this Darren the Banker?
It is. G'day, boys.
G'day, Daz.
G'day, Dazlop.
You got something for us?
I do. I know you boys love a business idea, right?
Yeah, we do.
Oh, yeah.
And I reckon I've got one.
All right, here we go.
Sit back.
So, went to the barbershop the other day, right? Yeah. Everyone's going to go to the barbershop to have their hair done. But I absolutely hate the small talk at the barbershop.
Me too.
With the barber or with other customers?
With the barber.
Okay.
What about if the person cutting your hair is attractive?
No, I can't cop it then either.
I can't cop it.
I just want to sit there and have my hair done. I just want to walk in and sit down and say, this is what I want, and I just want to sit there in silence. Hmm. I don't need chit-chat about what I'm doing for the weekend or what they're doing for the weekend or where I work or what I do. Just want to go in, get my hair done and out.
Righto. So what's the business idea?
I want a barbershop where you just walk in, you say what you want and then it's silence. A silent barbershop.
You know, you can get Uber. So you can, when you order an Uber, you can say no talking, no conversation.
Oh, that's where I've heard this idea before. But this is different.
This is different.
Yeah.
I reckon I've got one for you. Now, it might be right on the edge, but if I was to, I know what you're thinking about here, Dazzler. I reckon if I had my barbershop, it'd be called Shut Up Cut.
Shut up, cut. That is sensational. You do love a slogan, don't you?
Oh, Darren, I had some real lame ones. Yeah, that I penciled there. I was like, cut the small talk.
Oh, you that's know, good.
The, yeah, but no, it's not as good. I like, you got to be edgy. And
shut up, cunt.
Shut up, cunt. Oh, yes.
Wow. What about, yeah, no, actually, mine's nowhere near as good as yours.
Oh, that's very good. That's very good. It could be a business idea.
Now, Darren, in the meantime, I've seen this happen. I've been in the barbershop waiting to get my hair cut. You know, I've put my name down on the chalkboard. You know what the youngsters are doing these days? And it works. They just get their hair cut with the ear pods in.
Yes.
Oh. All right. So they just sit down and they sit down, they say what they want, and then they plug their ears with these things and they turn their music on, and that's it. The barber knows what's going on. They sit back and relax. End of story. Not bad.
I couldn't be that rude.
Yeah, that's
a bit rude.
No, but if you go to Shut Up Cut, you know that you're going to get a haircut and he's going to shut up. Hey, Dazzle, yep. Great Spot idea, on. Mate. Appreciate your call.
Thanks, boys. Love the work.
Good on you, Daz.
Now, boys, we've got a lot of feedback to get through, and there's a massive, massive whack for someone today.
Okay. Is that right?
A massive whack.
No, no, I've copped it.
I'm still trying to think of the punctuation used for Shut Up Cat. Shut Up Cat. I'm still trying to work it out. Would it be two slammers beforehand?
Shut
or?
Up, comma, cut. Is that what? Yeah. What's your slogan?
Shut Up Cat.
No, I think shut just up, cut. Shut up. With a little scissors in between and then cut.
Oh, yeah, nice, nice.
All right. Okay, feedback next.
Have a break. We'll do some feedback and someone needs to brace themselves.
This is the Couple of Blokes podcast with Ox and Marko. And as always, thanks to our great mates at E&S Trading. Make sure to subscribe and you'll never miss an episode. And it'd be great if you could rate and review us wherever you get your pods.
So I read last week where the NRL pundits are suggesting that Melbourne Storm will be garbage again this year.
Yep.
It's pretty standard for them,
pretty
isn't
standard.
It?
Hey, Harry Grant's our captain now.
Yeah. Bit of a rooster.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, good. Good.
He's a good-looking man.
Just back to the AFL for a moment.
Yeah.
Round zero?
Yeah, I'm in.
Oh, please.
I'm all in.
It is stupid.
I love it.
How can you have round zero?
Yeah, it's kind of like ground zero, but it's round zero.
Oh, yeah, yeah. The creative team at the AFL have just gone to new levels.
I don't mind it.
I don't like it. I don't like how they've changed the traditional opening game of the season and they're playing in Sydney for the first game. I don't like it.
But it's the Australian Football League.
No, but it is a stick it up your bum to Peter Vlandis.
That's right.
Because Peter Vlandis is... I love Peter Vlandis. Like, a lot of people don't. I love Peter Vlandis because he's antagonistic.
Yep.
A little bit quirky.
Yeah.
A bit like other people we know.
Yeah, but you want him on your team.
You want him on your team. So they've just done a Peter Vlandi. They've Peter Vlandied him.
Yeah.
That's what the AFL have done. So they've gone into Sydney and Queensland and just got captured a few eyeballs whilst they're gallivanting
but
around.
It's going to be the first ever full house Collingwood GWS, and it's going to be the first ever, it's going to be a full house at Sydney as well.
I forgot about that because I just looked at round one.
So you're going to get two full houses in Sydney. In ground zero round.
Yeah.
Can you go back to back?
Can Collingwood go back to back?
The only thing I'm worried about, Ox, is the three-peat. that's my only concern at the moment.
Really?
Okay. Although I'm one of these, I'm with you. What you said at the start of the show, the practice matches, you kind of watch through your fingers, you know.
Yeah.
Please no one get hurt. Please no one get hurt.
And Melbourne's new sponsor will help the Dees. Revolver. So I think that'll be a big bonus for the Demons.
So how are the Dees going to go this year?
I think they can win the flag or they can miss the eight. If the wheels fall off, if it's, you know, if there's as much fire as there is smoke, it could unravel. But they're a good side. They've got enough talent on the list. But if I'm a Melbourne supporter, I'm not expecting.
How big a loss, Brayshaw?
And huge. But sail them in the middle might change a few things. But as you know, Marko, you need luck. You just got to keep your good kettle on the park, and if you do that, you have a chance.
If you had to pick who's going to win the flag this year, I know you'd love the Dees too, I know you'd love the Pies too, but if you can park that for a moment, be detached, who do you think will win?
Oh, I think Collingwood. I think they're a very good side. Very well coached, very well organised. Yeah, and it looks like they're through their speed hump of of trouble, which Melbourne are probably going through right now.
Yeah, I like Brisbane. I think they're just they're just moving in the right direction.
They just can't seem to win at the G, though, can they?
Yeah, that's in the pointy end. That's the only bit. That is the only bit.
Yep.
Now, have we got some voicemail?
Oh, we do. The noise went off.
Okay.
So let's have a listen to it.
You have one new voicemail. New message.
G'day, boys. Horry here. You guys were talking about cars. I had panel vans as a young bloke and absolutely loved them because I was a tradie. You know, you had the curtains and you'd deck them out, so they were pretty comfy to sleep in after a Saturday football game and, you know, drinks at the club. You'd just have a snooze and drive home the next day. Done a fair bit of yabbying over the years too in the Bundura Golf Course Dam. That was sensational as a kid. And your pod's just fantastic. And thanks for all the great memories. Just listening to all your stories is brilliant. All right, boys, keep up the good work. Cheers.
The old pedal van. The old shag and wagon.
You know, Horry, he sounds like a bloke I would love to have six pots with.
He doesn't sound like a tradie, though.
Nah, he doesn't.
No, does he?
But he sounds like a ripper. How long does it take you? How many sentences out of somebody's mouth does it take you to know that you'd be very happy having a beer with that character?
Yeah, once I find out his name, because the name of a person will determine if he's a good bloke.
So who won't? Really? Would you drink with a Neville?
Yeah, I like Nebs. Yeah, okay. Yeah, like Nevilles, like Nigels.
What about a Randy? If you're in America, would you have a drink with Randy?
Oh, I know one Randy, and he's a good bloke from the Altona Basketball Club.
Really? You've got a Randy in Altona?
Yeah.
Is he an Aussie guy?
No, American.
Yeah, okay.
American doing the basketball. And
I've got to say,
very good bloke.
Altona's not known for their Randys.
No.
No, they are not.
No, he does stand out.
Chad?
Yeah, see, Chad and Bryson's and all those American buffhead names.
Yeah.
Not massive on them.
No.
Graham's, if I get a good Graham, a good Kevy.
Kevy's a drinking name.
Kevy's a good name. There are some names you just know. If you named a certain what's the worst one? I was talking about this the other day.
What about Tristan? Ones. Would you have 15 pots with Trissy? With Trissy?
No way. Not a chance. Not a Tristan.
Trissy's, but
I don't even know a Tristan, do I?
I don't know.
No, you've got to stay away from
there. Is there a Tristan in the AFL or a Tristan in the NRL?
Nah, I wouldn't have thought so.
Yeah.
It's not a tough name.
No. Tristan is not a tough name.
No, Tristan's a name that might get you a little bit, maybe a little bit beaten up, I reckon.
Yeah, as a kid, you get bashed.
Good luck getting through school if your parents call you Tristan.
By your parents.
So there's a reporter on there's a reporter on Channel 9, a guy called Reed Butler, and every time I see him I think, you went to a private school. And he went to private school from how he looks and the name Reed.
Yeah, I've seen Reed.
There is no Reed who ever went to a public school.
There's a Reed playing for Kentucky in college basketball at the moment, and he's a gun. He's a freshman in the first year or second?
Yeah, freshman's first year.
He shot 32 against Mississippi State the other day and a game winner on the buzzer.
Is he playing with Furphy, the kid from Melbourne? There's a kid from Melbourne who plays.
Oh, it might be.
He plays at is it Kentucky or Kansas? Furphy plays for Kansas.
Yeah. But this kid, he's Reed. You don't see too many Reeds.
I'd drink with a Reed though.
Yeah.
I'd probably have a shardy with Reed.
What about Bo's?
What?
Bo's are good. Yeah.
Bo's a good value.
Yeah, Reed would drink shardy. Reed would drink.
Now, Decker. I'm not drinking with Derek. I'm not drinking with any Derricks.
Is that from Derek Humphrey Smith?
Yeah,
style
could be.
Derek?
Could be.
I saw him the other day.
Did you?
Yeah, I saw him.
He'd be at Scotts College.
He was worse. He was at Sorrento Golf Club.
Oh, wow.
He was there with his
kid. Was he wearing a cardigan?
No, it was a hot day, but I wouldn't put it past
Decker. Oh, yeah.
You know who you would have a beer with, though? For sure.
Yeah.
Duncan.
Oh yeah, Duncan's my mate.
Of course. Have to. You'd love to.
What a great... I haven't heard that song for a long... Yeah. Can we play that as a reprise at the end of our...
Duncan's my mate.
Yeah, we'll play a bit of it.
All right.
We'll do a bit of it. Now, feedback time, boys.
Okay.
Mick Anderson's written in.
Ando.
G'day, lads. You sent a photo in. Have a look at that photo that I've just sent you guys.
Yeah.
G'day, lads. How's this for some civil selfishness? Parking in a disabled spot with no disabled sticker at Dramana Richie's RGA. What a prick.
And it's a Silverado, so it's the biggest car anyway.
It's a truck. It's a Kenworth.
It is a truck.
It's a Kenworth truck.
I saw one of them driving down the road the other day and $100 bills just coming out of the exhaust pipe. Just, they're so expensive on juice.
They're getting so big. I mean, They kind of look fun to drive to me.
Yeah.
I would like to take one for a spin.
Do you know how much petrol, just talking about petrol in cars, do you know how much petrol is in New Zealand right now?
What do you mean? When you say, you mean how expensive it is?
It's always later. Cost a lot.
$3.30.
What, New Zealand pesos?
Yeah, but the peso's not far off the Aussie dollar now. It's about $1.05. So,
okay.
So it works out to be about $3.10 for a litre of petrol.
My God.
I know.
Yeah, it's always been really expensive over there.
Jeez.
Some more feedback here. We're talking Married with Children and Frasier and all that sort of stuff recently.
Why are you trying to get Frasier in again?
We're with Ted Bundy.
Yeah, with Ted Bundy.
Al Bundy.
Oh, jeez, you cop some wax on the over there.
I know.
Oh, jeez, people are lining you up.
I know.
And they're getting pretty vicious. I think, jeez, like, come on, we made a mistake.
Slip of the tongue.
Yeah. Vito's written in, Married with Children was a fantastic, funny series. I still watch the reruns.
Yeah, good.
That's what Vito reckons.
Yeah. I watched a rerun the other day.
Of Married with Children.
Yeah, it was very good. It was very good. And Bart just giving it to his sister.
Bud
just giving it to his sister. What's his sister's name again?
Christina Applegate.
Yeah, like, just giving it to the sister about all the boys she dates.
Floozy.
Oh,
yeah.
It was just so funny.
Franklin said, Married with Children, the best ever and, in his view, the hottest TV mum ever.
What? Peggy?
Peggy.
Peggy hot.
Listen, Peggy has her place in TV world, but it is not that place.
Who do you think? Well, who's your hottest TV mum in history?
Elizabeth Montgomery.
Bewitched.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
In her prime. Barbara Eden.
Who's Barbara? Oh, hang on.
Audrey Magini.
Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah.
What was the show Michael J. Fox was in?
Family Ties.
Family Ties.
Yeah, yeah, that blonde lady. Yeah, she was hot.
What about the mum?
Who's the boss?
Oh, wow.
I'm trying to remember the mum in that.
Scott Baio and the blonde lady, the blonde-haired lady. Mm.
Didn't you like Mr. Sheffield, what's her name, the nanny? Didn't you like Fran Drescher?
Fran Drescher, yeah, she was all right. Her voice was a turn-on.
Guys, another bit of feedback here. Oh, yeah, it really was. This is from PJ. Hey, guys, listening to a recent pod, couldn't miss the chance to send a couple of pics of my big buck hunter machine that I bought in reference to your chat about buying things for no reason, aside from just to feel good. Hopefully you can zoom in and see the signature of a couple of blokes who worked for a certain radio station that I bought from an auction on the Friday afternoon show.
Unreal.
Yeah, the betting exchange.
That was big, that betting exchange. Yeah. What was the craziest thing you ever sold on the betting exchange?
We had some really good stuff. We had a car.
Yeah.
We won a car.
Explain, for those who didn't listen, because I wasn't part of this show.
So Dr. Turf used to choose a side and we would put up, say, a TV, or one of our sponsors would put up a barbecue or a lawnmower, and then you'd put up something and he'd choose the best item. And whatever we won went to charity.
Yeah.
And if you happen to win, you win the TV or whatever. And we won some amazing – but we there's a guy put up a Redline BMX and we got beaten by a point.
Oh.
I would have bought it. But we won a big buck hunter. We won fridges. We won some amazing stuff.
It's a great name, isn't it? Buck Hunter.
Yeah, big buck hunter.
Buck Hunter. Yeah. Come back and let's play Buck Hunter.
Now, speaking of BMXs, see that photo there? Rocks in front of you.
I know, the mongoose.
Jason Casey sent a photo of a mongoose in for you.
Oh, my God.
That is the most... That bike is the most beautiful, like all of us, I'm a teenager again.
Yeah.
It's art.
That is art. That's what it is. It is art. That's the Van Gogh of BMXs.
I always dreamed about, you know, what do you call the seat pole? Is that what it's called?
No, it's called
a different name.
No. Well, the gooseneck was at the front and then you had the...
Yeah, well, the pole that the seat fits on, the little curl back, so it gave you just a little extra room.
Yeah. And it was aluminium. Oh, God.
It's a beautiful bike.
Staggering.
Yep. Beautiful bike. Kevin Hawson, another photo in. Hey, guys, have a look at this. Look at that photo I've just sent you. Poth Road. This is in Melbourne. Poth Road in Murrumbina and Hughesdale is a dividing line between the city of Monash and the city of Glen Ira. Literally, the middle of the road is the border.
One side's done and the other side's not.
How ridiculous.
So which side's done?
So the city of Monash paid to fix all their potholes, and that looks beautiful. Like that road
it's
there,
a beautiful
gorgeous,
road.
And they resurfaced it. Glen Ira chose not to.
Well, why wouldn't you do the same road at the same time and actually collaborate? I'll tell you why, because councils are dickheads.
That's exactly right.
They are a bunch of dicks.
Dickheads.
Yes.
Average. We were talking, I think maybe 2 weeks ago, about Rodney Dangerfield.
Yes.
I can't remember the content. Oh, it was about Caddyshack.
Caddyshack, yeah.
Caddyshack, when you made the very outrageous
statement. Very overrated movie.
Oh, my God. do not even start. That's actually...
I don't know where that came from.
It's unbelievable that you say that. Anyway, we're talking Dangerfield. And last week we talked about maths because we had a message from Dave from Lonnie whose wife is watching it, and he's kind of been sucked into watching it as well.
Yeah.
Brett has written in. The discussion you had about Rodney Dangerfield. For the maths watchers, one of the bride's dads is a dead ringer for Rodney Dangerfield. It is uncanny. He wore a suit that was orange and carried about his daughter's marriage. He sent a photo in of this dude from maths and of the Dangerfield.
Can you please post that?
Yeah, we will.
Oh, my goodness.
It's like if you said they were brothers.
Yeah, you wouldn't be far off.
You wouldn't think twice. You'd just agree. You'd go, wow, all right, that's Rodney Dangerfield's brother.
It does.
He lives in Australia.
It's so crazy.
Okay, a couple of things to wrap up on. This is the whack. You ready for it?
Yep.
Why are you looking at me?
No, why are you looking at me? Why are you looking at both of us?
Who do you reckon's copping it?
Oh, well, I'll cop it between the eyes.
You.
This is from Legend of Sunshine.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. He's living in Sunshine. There we go. Too much
he's
of a legend.
He's on the Bayside bloke, I bet.
No, he's not. I want him to come out to Sunbury because us Sunbury boys used to punch the shit out of the Sunshine. Actually, the Sunbury boys used to fight the Sunshine boys to get to the good fights.
That was a progress, was it?
Yeah.
That was the prelude.
No, you start down the bottom and work your way up.
So, Legend of Sunshine, who I've always thought's a good bloke, I may now be rethinking that.
Good.
Third Man.
Yeah. Oh, you're copying it.
Good.
Is showing that he's a full-on entitled lefty flog.
Yes.
By stealing fruit, clogging up the 12-item register.
Yes.
Posting anti-liberal memes.
Yes.
Boot off drip.
Yes. Correct.
That's pretty harsh.
But accurate
Well, drip is harsh. Drip is harsh, but everything else is accurate.
Full-on entitled lefty flog.
Well, you're a lefty, aren't you?
We still love you, Dan.
I wouldn't know the difference between left and right anyway.
I do sit on the left. I am a natural lefty.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you know how I only worked that out
I'm bipartisan.
Yeah. I'm a swing voter too.
Yeah.
I always have been.
You've been a swinger your whole life. Everyone knows that.
Now, we had a poll recently, guys. This is on your outrageous claim recently. Actually, I think you made this claim, Ox, about Marko getting hit on by a cop.
Yes.
Now, we did a poll on that.
I still believe it.
Here's the question. Unbelievably, Mark Allen is convinced that the Ox is onto something when he says the cop who pulled Marko over was flirting with him. What do you think? And we had four options.
Right.
Yes, the story checks out.
Yep.
Second option. Possibly.
That's what I voted for.
Possibly might be accurate. Third, I'd say very unlikely. Fourth, zero chance.
Yep.
Okay. In last place. Yep, story checks out, 7%.
I'm one of those 7% too.
In second last place, I'd say very unlikely, 21%.
It says 28 gone.
In third place, possibly accurate, 25%.
Oh, this is a
46%, zero chance.
Bullshit.
You were not hit on by a cop.
That was bullshit.
I still think it could be right.
I don't believe it is. Final bit of feedback, guys, from Justin Descent. G'day, legends. Miss you blokes on the airways for the last couple of years. Last night, I discovered your pod. I've listened to 3 episodes today while I'm working. Everything is good in the world again. Cheers.
Yay.
Isn't that nice of Justin?
Well done.
Good on you, Jazzy.
Nice. So, time for a joke. Ox, you want to give the wheel a spin over there?
Here we go. You're not going to believe it.
What?
It's a police joke. It's a police joke. Okay, got one.
What you got?
All right, this is about police but criminals. Did you hear about the criminal who stole a lamp?
No.
He got a very light sentence.
Yeah. Very nice, very nice.
Good stuff.
Knock, knock.
Who's that?
Dishes.
Dishes who?
Dishes the police. Open up.
Thanks, boys.
Good right. stuff.
See you next time.
It's a lonesome away from your kindred and all by the campfire.
And thanks for listening to the Couple of Blokes podcast with Ox and Marko. And if you get a chance to share it with a friend, that'd be fantastic. Massive thanks to the team at the E&S Trading Clearance Centre in Clayton on Dandenong Road. And if you're not in Melbourne, you can check them out online. Some massive savings. Couple of Blokes executive producer is Dan Bradley at Kaizen Media and sound design from Daryl Misson at loudzebra.com. We'll see you next time.
Far away, look on the face of the bum. The maid's gone all cranky and the cook's acting queer. Oh, what a terrible place is a pub with no beer.